Come, come. You should feel better. Take care.
I have arranged a meeting with my uncle Ahmed and the Janissary captain, Tariq Barlateh. The Janissaries are loyal. My grandfather, but they have lately become angry over his choice of the next sultan.
Your uncle?
Exactly. The Janissaries prefer my father, Selim.
You are in a tough spot. But how do the Byzantines fit into this?
I had hoped you might know. Would you be willing to help me find out?
I am tracking them myself. I can help you, as long as our interests run parallel.
I will take what I can get. There is a hatch at the top of that tower which leads to a secret room. Go there, wait, and watch.
Most interesting.
Why?
Heed my nephew, Tariq. Your incompetence borders on treason. And to think that today, your Janissaries were outshone by an Italian lute player. Preposterous.
An inexcusable failing, Effendim. I will conduct a full investigation.
I will conduct the investigation, Tariq. For reasons that should be obvious.
Evet, Shehzadem. You have your father's wisdom.
And his impatience. Uncle, I am relieved to see you safe.
Likewise, Suleiman. Allaha emanet olun. Tariq Bey, a word. What was the purpose of this attack, I wonder? To make me look weak? An ineffective steward of the city? If you are the hand in this mess, Tariq, you have made a grave mistake. My father has chosen me as the next sultan, not my brother.
Ahmed. I am not depraved enough to imagine the conspiracy you accuse me of.
What have I done to earn such contempt from the Janissaries? What has my brother done for you that I have not?
May I speak freely?
You'd better.
You're weak, Ahmed. Pensive in times of war and restless in times of peace. You lack passion for the traditions of the Ghazi, yet you speak of fraternity in the company of infidels. You make a decent philosopher, Ahmed. But you will be a poor sultan.
You may show yourself out.
Quite a family,
Your uncle lacks sway over the men he will soon command.
Tariq is a hard man. Proud and capable, but ambitious. And he admires my father greatly.
But he failed to secure this palace against the Byzantine invasion. That alone is worth our attention.
Precisely.
Where should we begin?
For now, keep an eye on Tariq and his Janissaries. They spend much of their free time in and around the bazaar.
I will start there when I can.
Let me get out of your way!
Cara, the strings of fate have drawn us together. Two Italiani, lost and alone in the Orient. Do you not feel the magnetismo?
I feel many things, Messere. Nausea, above all.
Is this man bothering you, Sofia?
Excuse me, Messere, but the lady and I are... Oh! Il diavolo in persona! Stay back!
Duccio, a pleasure.
Run, buona donna! Run for your life!
Who was that?
Un cane. He was engaged to my sister many years ago.
And what happened?
His cazzo was engaged to six others. Chiedo venia. So what brings you to these docks?
I took a break from my work to retrieve a package. But here they claim the captain's papers are not in order. So I wait. Che seccatura. I could be here all day.
Let me see what I can do. I know a few ways to bend the rules.
Do you now?
Si. I will meet you back at your shop.
Sartor. Perfetto.
Stop! You there!
What the fuck is this? It matches the description.
What?
It is to be held before the fort. The recent troubles have quieted enough.
Salute, Ezio. Any luck?
Mademigella Sofia Sartor, Libraia, Constantinopoli.
Oh no, look at the damage. Did they use this to fight off pirates? Well, so far so good. Ah, beautiful, no? This is a print of a map by Martin Waldseemüller. See? The new lands described by Messer Amerigo Vespucci.
Or Cristoforo Colombo. History has a strange way of unfolding.
What do you make of this body of water here?
A new ocean, perhaps. Most of the scholars I know claim the size of the globe has been underestimated.
Incredibile. The more we learn about the world, the less we seem to know. Well, you honored your promise. Here is mine fulfilled. If we are correct, this should show you the location of the first book. I must admit, my head is swimming with the prospect of seeing these books. This is knowledge the world has lost, and must have again. Perhaps I could print a few copies to distribute myself. A small run of 50 or so, that should be enough. Perché ridi?
Forgive me. It is a joy to see someone with a passion so personal and noble. It is inspiring.
Goodness, where is this coming from?
Grazie, Sofia. I will return. Thank you.
not express my wonder.
You won't find this stuff anywhere. The best one. The rarest one. The money's worth it. An exclusive.
An addition to the family soon. I've not been able to put much aside yet, but if God grants I may remain knee-deep in flour, nuts, and honey, it should not take long.
Can you take Altan to the Medrese tomorrow and Wednesday? I must leave to meet my caravan at dawn. I will be gone most of the week on this job. We are very busy now, the main merchants have reopened. What of you? I have not seen the little ones in weeks. I've been so busy. Are they still like tiny dervishes breaking everything in sight? Oh, and will you be adding the new extension to the shop?
No, no. Things are much better, thank you. I am helping with a new mosque near the gate. It is hard, but spiritually fulfilling work. It will be most beautiful when it is finished. But that will take many years. I keep making the trip between the Horn and Üsküdar to find the right ingredients. I only want the best. Sometimes the Grand Bazaar is disappointing, and going straight to the source is necessary. My clients appreciate my dedication, I'm sure.
I hear your son is working for that Italian architect, the one restoring the Venetian church near the docks. When that job is done, tell him to come see me. I could use a man of his talents, especially as he is young, earnest, and relatively cheap.
I noticed the pilgrims returning to the old churches. I also remarked they have great thirst, hunger, and need of trinkets to bring home. I started to provide for their needs, and have already hired two assistants.
Let us hope the recent change in administration is permanent. I would hate to go back to the way things were under Commander Dung-Eater the Byzantine. I really hope someone gutted him slowly. God forgive me.
With the pirates' renewed industry, the Christian pilgrims increasingly avoid the sea to reach the Holy Land. They pass through here, and take interest in the old Byzantine churches and relics. My business thrives.
My wife's voice is most shrill, penetrating. It's funny, but I have been so busy this last while, I have barely seen her. Her condition makes her agitated, but sleepy. Though by God, I do love her, a little respite is sometimes welcome.
I heard your brother is now working for the Beylik administration. This is quite a step up for him. Send him my sincere admiration for his achievement. And my best to your father, of course.
I must soon head to the docks for business. What a relief we do not have to pay the damn steward mooring tax anymore. What a bureaucratic policing that was. Its repeal has made my business thrive once more.
Best aboard the guard, though.
Giving us the credit?
Revival is dead. Known as the stewards of Byzantium, these thugs need
language fails to offer a means of describing.
Aid your guardmen and report any information you may have on him.
Be back from his business.
Thank you.
smashed it.
The army fielded by the Sultan will no doubt soon be covered.
Please accept my apologies, Effendi.
Why, William?
Another madman.
You held fire in your hand, old man. It should have been destroyed.
Destroy the only thing capable of ending the Crusades and creating true peace? Never.
Forgive me for this, Mentor. But the apple corrupted you, and through you it would have corrupted us. For us to live, you had to die.
Is it truly over? Is that sorcerer dead?
He was no sorcerer. Just an ordinary man in command of illusions. Have you prepared the pyre?
I have, but... Altair, some of the men will not stand for such a thing.
Let me handle it. Are you fit to travel?
Well enough, yes.
I asked Malik to ride to Jerusalem with news of Al-Mulim's death. Would you ride to Acre and do the same?
Of course.
Oh, was I hallucinating?
Am I dreaming?
What happened?
So much confusion. What is happening?
How did it come to this?
My mind was clear, but my body, it would not move.
Was our mentor the cause of this confusion?
I do not believe
it.
What has happened here?
Our mentor deceived us all. The Templars corrupted him.
Where is your proof?
Walk with me, Abbas, and I will explain.
And if I find your answers wanting,
I will talk until you are satisfied. Do you remember the artifact we recovered from Robert de Sau in Solomon's Temple?
The artifact you were sent to retrieve, but others delivered?
Yes. It is a Templar tool. The Apple of Eden. It can conjure illusions and control men's minds. A deadly weapon.
And you believe Al-Mualim fell under its spell?
I do. Today he used the Apple to enslave Masyaf. You saw that for yourself.
I do not know what I saw.
Listen, Abbas. The Apple is safe in Al-Mualim's study. When I'm finished here, I will show you all I know.
Altair! No!
I must know that he cannot return.
But this is not our way. To burn a man's body is forbidden.
Defiler!
Hear me out. This body could be another one of Al-Mualim's phantoms. I must be certain.
Lies! All your life, you have made a mockery of our creed. You bend the rules to suit your whims, while belittling and humiliating those around you.
Restrain him!
Did you not hear him? Al-Mualim is bewitched.
What did I tell you, Altair?
Abbas! Stop!
What did you think would happen when you murdered our beloved mentor?
You loved Al-Mualim less than anyone! You blamed him for all your misfortune, even your father's suicide.
My father was a hero!
This is not the time to quarrel over the past. We must decide what to do with that weapon.
Whatever this artifact is capable of, you are not worthy to wield it!
No man is.
It is beautiful, is it not?
Ah!
What was that?
Are they dead? Forgive me. I did not know.
Have you anything to teach us? Would you lead us all to ruin? Altair, barely 26, and already a Grandmaster in command of a divided order. How does one cope with such responsibility and unlimited power? I made the acquaintance of an Ottoman prince named Suleiman. He's a clever young man, with a fortitude uncommon for his age. On his suggestion, I will be investigating some wayward Janissaries, who may be in league with the Templars. With luck, they will lead me straight to the core of the Templars' leadership. Meanwhile, the Venetian Sophia Sartor continues to help me find the hidden Masyaf keys. She is a diligent woman, full of passion and vigor, and I enjoy her company immensely. But I dare not tell her the purpose of my stay here, nor of my true vocation. Those who do not volunteer in our struggle should not be forced to fight it.